Hey, Shalom, praise unto Yahweh Hashem, Hashabah, Shimon Kakadash, double honors unto the apostles of great millstone, and honest you brothers that be pushing this truth and sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. So this is going to be a quick video, a little update in the World War III algorithm, if you will. I don't know if I had a better word to use than that. You know, I don't know too much about the ins and outs of what's going on in the global economy. On the global social political thing that's happening out there, but we know from the scriptures that there is going to be a World War III, and therefore it's needful to watch out for little articles like this and to do videos on them. Now, there are brothers within the camp of Great Millstone that go into a great deal of detail in expressing and revealing particular nuances pertaining to the global economic sphere. I'm just going to dwell on the superficial for a little while in order to put the point across that there's going to be a World War III and these nations are allying themselves against the United States and taking steps towards a unified front against Babylon the Great, which is America, according to the scriptures. So without much further ado, I'm going to go into this particular article and in a series of scriptures to bolster my point. So it says here, China inks military deal with Iran under secretive 25-year plan. And what you are noticing throughout the four corners of the earth is a move against the dollar, a move against America, a move against the way of doing things now that benefits Esau and disproportionately disbenefits the nations that are non-Edomite nations. That is to say, Esau being the Americans, the British, the French, the Spanish, and so on and so forth, greatly benefit from whatever deal is struck, or whatever nation we're talking about, whether it be an OPEC deal, or whether it be a manufacturing deal, a food product deal. These nations get savaged by Esau because he is the true savage. They don't get savaged, sorry, that's the wrong word to use, but they get... they get stripped of their resources from Esau because he's the man that rules the world right now. And the scripture talks about how that he cannot have enough. And so the Most High set up a trap, a jinn, as the scripture says, against Esau. And he's not going to know from whence it cometh. Because they are planning the World War III, but it's going to get out of hand. And it's going to be that these nations are going to come up against Babylon, which is America. So this plan here is in direct opposition to the sanctions that America put upon Iran. And I believe China's got particular sanctions that have been imposed against it. And, America has been putting all kind of sanctions on these different countries. And as a result, these nations are making deals with each other and finding alternative ways to survive. And this deal being one of those particular examples. Continuing, it says, last August, Iran's foreign minister, Mohammad Zarif, paid a visit to China, to his China counterpart, Wang Li, to present a roadmap on a comprehensive 25-year, and we ain't going to be here for another 25 years, a comprehensive 25-year China-Iran strategic partnership that will build up upon a previous agreement signed in 2016. Many of the key specifics of the updated agreement were not released to the public at the time, but were uncovered by oilprice.co.uk.com rather more. Last week, a meeting at the Jilan province, former Iran President Mohammad Ahmad Danijad alluded to some of the secret parts of this deal in public for the first time, saying it's not valid to enter into a secret agreement with foreign parties without considering the will of the Iranian nation and and against the interests of the country and the nation. So it goes on and it continues. All right, what we're interested in is this point here. Let's see if I can quickly find it. Right. What we're always interested in is the war games that get played out on the global economic sphere. And it's playing out just like how the scripture says, man. The weak was going to say they're strong because they're going to join up in league with these other major nations. I should have really put a bookmark or something to help me find it. So I might be able to search in here. Am I going to be able to search? No. I'll find it. I'll find it. You brothers just bear with me whilst I look for this this key point. Right, here we go. It's just a bit. You know, these, you know, we don't script these videos out, so sometimes, you know, it doesn't come out so smooth, but if you're patient, the information is going to be given to you, and you're going to see the relevance. So here's the bit I was looking for. Now, though, another element that will change the entire balance of the geopolitical power in the Middle East. And then that's, like I said, it's a juicy article. It's juicy. And you're going to go through, look how much information we had to go through to get to that bit. We had to go through quite a bit to find that particular bit. But it's an important bit. And it goes into the scriptures. Because when we read the Bible, I read it in a second within the book of 2 Ezra, the 15th chapter. How the Carmanians are going to rage within their old wrath. Paraphrasing a little bit there. But the Iranians are those ancient Persians, and those ancient Persians knew of warfare. Right now they've been pushed into this corner of submission, and it's all good and well right now, but guess what? People return to their truest nature if you push them into a corner. It says there now, though, another element that will change the entire balance of the geopolitical power within the Middle East has been added to the deal. Last week, Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei, I don't know how to pronounce that particular name, agreed to the extension of the existing deal to include new military elements that were proposed by the same senior figures in the IRGC, the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, and intelligence services that proposed the original deal. And this will involve the complete aerial, naval military cooperation between Iran, China, with Russia also taking a key role. You see that? Now, if these are all countries that have been sanctioned against by America, and they all presenting a unified front, who are they taking a unified front against? If you've got China as a major power, Russia as a major geopolitical power, and Iran as a small power that's got very a tense relationship with America, why would they be a joint, who would be the joint military cooperation be against? You got a little brother within the family, he's got a problem with somebody. And the big brother, two big brothers come to him. Who do you think those two big brothers are going to be allied with the little brother to go up against? Whoever's picking on their little brother, man. And that's what you're seeing with these nations. They're starting to show a joint front against Esau. Let me read that again so you brothers at home pick up on that little point there. It says, and you can find this same article on Zero Hedge as well. This will involve complete aerial, which means to say the fighter jets, naval, the fighter jets that go on the Chinese, because America's got aircraft carriers, but China, 10 aircraft carriers, in fact, that America has. And China is the closest, the country with the closest amount of aircraft carriers in comparison to America. And China's got, what, 3 aircraft carriers. So they're behind, but they're trying to put some type of, dent in terms of comparison against America. Now, when you look at Russia's geopolitical strategy against foreign powers, they figured that they don't have the petrol dollar, therefore the investment, the money to build aircraft carriers, like America has built aircraft carriers, 10 and counting. They focused on their weapons technology, the Sarmat 1, or the Satan 1 missile, the Satan 2 missile, which are all missiles that inevitably are going to be used against the United States, because that's what the Bible says, that's what the scripture says. So let's read that little last bit again to bolster up the point that I've been trying to make all throughout this video, which is that World War III is inevitable, and it's going to culminate with America, China, going up against China, Iran, Russia, a World War III, if you will. And this will involve a complete aerial and naval cooperation between Iran, China, with Russia also taking a key role. So let's read the scriptures now. Let's read the scriptures. The book of Joel, the 3rd chapter, the 10th verse. Beat your plowshares into swords. This is going to go hand in hand with the scripture that I'm going to read within the book of 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter, around about the 40th verse. How that these nations, more specifically Iran in this particular example, are going to move from a position of being relatively silent and quiet and minding their own business, quote unquote, to a position where they are confidently coming up against America. There's videos out there within Iran of them speaking up against the United States. Beat your plowshares into swords. Now, here's the counter to this, because the Heavenly Father works in balance. There's also a scripture that says, beat your swords into plowshares, beat your pruning hooks into, beat your spears into pruning hooks. Because there's a time of war and there's a time of peace, and the time of peace is going to come when the King of Peace, which is Yahweh Shai, has got his throne. But in order for that throne to be established, there must needs be a World War III. And the scripture says, in the midst of the World War III, was Yahweh Shai going to intervene, stop these nations from fighting up against each other, and they was going to fight up against Yahweh Shai and lose. That's within the book of 2nd Ezra, the 13th chapter. Beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak, which is Iran, which is a relatively, like Iran rather more, which is a relatively weak superpower, if you will, within the global geopolitical system. They're relatively weak. The scripture says there that let the weak say I am strong, because they're going to feel strong with the support of their allies, this being a major superpower, China, and another major superpower, Russia. And now let's conclude this particular lesson with this scripture here within the book of 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter. And this is the 2nd Ezra 15 and 30. Also the Carmenians, which is another word for Iranians. Also the Carmenians, rather more, it's talking about the same people. Raging in the wrath shall go forth as wild boars off the wood with great power, and they shall come and join battle with them. Battle with who? The same countries that we've mentioned a second ago. And join battle with them, and they shall waste a portion of Assyria. Now, people might say, oh, you know, that's talking about back in the day. But when you read the rest of the scripture, the rest of the book of 2nd Ezra, the 15th chapter, it's clearly talking about a future prophecy. What is a modern day? What is the modern day Assyria? Let's cast our minds back into the history and understand what happened within the history and map it out to the times that we're living in right now. Because as the book of Ecclesiastes, the 1st chapter on the 9th verse says, there's no new thing underneath the sun. Back in the day, you had it to where Assyria was the superpower of the world. They controlled everything that happened within the world, and the Media Persians came up against them. So what's the modern day superpower? America is the modern day superpower that governs what happens within the earth, that polices of the world, that polices the world, that governs. Governs and police goes hand in hand together. The scripture, you know, there's plenty of articles saying America is the police of the world. So you get the understanding on that. And when we go through the scriptures, because the scriptures was written in code, there's particular land masses that were historic, but their name was used prophetically. Okay, there's historic land masses that was used prophetically, like the name Babylon, and this instance Assyria. So Assyria is going to be essentially be destroyed, because it's just like, you know, you know, like he's America is known by the name Assyria within the scriptures. Sometimes it's talking about the ancient Assyria, and sometimes it's talking about the prophetic Assyria. Same word as Babylon, same word as Egypt, or more same application. All right, so that's it. You know, hopefully that was of edification. With that, I'm gonna say all praise unto Yah Bashim Yashai Bashim Kakadash, double honors unto the apostles, a great millstone, and honestly, brothers, to be pushing this truth in sincerity. Shalom.